Across the shore, in distant lands, with dark stars overhead, the prince was fast asleep until a cat jumped on his bed.
"I've found a secret garden,"
said the cat with much delight. Excitedly, they ran outside, explorers in the night. They walked through the golden garden gate.
"Look at the pretty trees."
They walked along the pretty pebble path.
"Look at the colorful flowers."
They walked past the fabulous flowing fountain.
"Look at the dancing water. Look, look, look."
But the prince didn't like the garden and started kicking down the trees. He dug up flowers, grabbed the hedges, and pulled off all the leaves. He ruined everything for fun. The cat watched on in fear.
"What a mistake I made,"
the cat cried out.
"I should never have brought him here."
When the rabbit came to visit, the prince said, "Time to play." But his big red eyes, they scared her, and she didn't want to stay. Quickly towards the exit, the tiny rabbit hopped. The prince ran right behind her and screamed, "She must be stopped!" through dark. The prince, he couldn't catch her. His heart was filled with wrath. The rabbit slipped right out the door and vanished down the path. The prince cried out, "I need new friends. More, now, another."
"I'll bring you some, don't worry now," replied his loving, caring mother. It was cold throughout the palace. The moon shone bright outside. The wind, it blew and blew. Oh no! The curtains flew open wide. The little prince was in his bed and couldn't get to sleep. So he called out for his mother, "Please go and find my sheep." "I'm thirsty," said the prince. So the sheep fetched a drink. "I'm dirty," said the prince. So the sheep changed his clothes.
"I'm tired,"
said the prince. "Let me count you. 1, 2, 3. "Just one more thing," said the prince, "before I drift to sleep." He opened up his big red eyes and turned to face the sheep. "Come join me in my dreams. Stay forever in my head." Obediently, the sheep stepped forth, its mind consumed by dread.
Thank you. Thank you. January 22nd, log 285. My daughter returned home intact as a new yellow sight. The baby and his sitters so far remain unaware of my activities. Is it egotistical that I made the door open? That's awful. Yes, go on. Should I be driven mad and forget my duties, I leave this recording as a reminder. Never open the door. And never allow the Jarrah's fear to stop us.
bring him here? What have you done?